So I was gonna list the interviews once they're done online, because I was talking about before. Just so people are curious, and I started like the one form of like interview analysis. It's just interesting. But yeah, I'm this really excited about this like open form, open source. Like, I don't know if any of us are interested, we can use it for whatever.
I'm just so excited at this moment. I'm not sunny. It's fascinating. It's like extra layer of fascination.
So the forum is like, if you already have a like detailed memory, you can just dive right in, and then if not, or in any case, if it's interesting to you, to kind of do like a normal telling of the session. Like nothing fancy or particular about it, just like I remember this and this and this and this. And then we can kind of like zero in on the moment. Or if you're already at the moment's clear, you can just dive in as much as you want.
Okay. Yeah. So it's already some weeks ago.
Yeah.
But maybe that's good, because I don't remember a lot in detail. I just have some kind of moments that stuck to me. And I remember that it took me some time to get into the situation, to feel comfortable. At the beginning I was a little stiff somehow, and I couldn't really I couldn't really read the person I was dancing with first, so I had trouble to reach her a little bit. Like, is she playful? Is she curious? Is she coming towards me? Is she trying to avoid me? Because there were some situations that were forth and back, which was interesting, but I noticed that it was confusing me at that moment. Then I remember that there were some rather fast and playful parts where we were running around. I think you and what was her name? Was it Daniela, were initiating that, and it was kind of bringing an energy in that was great, because it kind of took me out of that situation. And then that was nice. And then I remember very much the moment when you gave in this task to focus on a moment, or you gave several options to visualize or to imagine a situation. I took a situation with another person that was rather difficult for me, or very emotional. And then you said to let it go through your body, and then kind of let it wash away. I think, I don't know if I remember, that was kind
that's
of
great.
That's kind of what I remember. Okay. That was what I took from it. And
super.
Kind of, I really liked that. So we were lying, I was going into this situation back, and then try to let it go, sort of, but still see what my body makes with it.
Totally.
And that was an approach I never had with dancing or anything in moving. And it was really interesting to see how different my interaction in that situation, for example, with you was, because I really, it took me a while to notice actually with whom I was dancing, but not, I was aware of what you were doing and I was aware of what I was doing, but it was not important who you were at that moment, or what kind of person you are, or what kind of, it kind of, so everything made sense that you did, because it was kind of this answer of my, you were answering my, how should I put it? You were kind of the part that I was responding to with my feelings that I brought into this scene. Yeah. So, and it was really interesting. Cool. I don't know if that makes sense. So
it does. Strangely, it's sort of a world I study a lot. So I'm like, it's like dream language or something.
Yeah,
I'm like, it does and doesn't always at the same time.
Yeah. But it was especially interesting to me because before I mentioned this situation where I was confused and couldn't read, and but I was obviously looking for something at that moment. It's kind of what I thought afterwards, because I was, I mean, you get confused if you're looking for something and you don't find what, you don't find orientation somehow, I guess. That's kind of the reason why people get nervous or confused. And it was basically probably the same situation, but my mindset was different. I was not looking for something from outside, but I was coming up with something I had in me and kind of brought that into the dance. And it changed my perception of what was going on and my feelings to it.
Yeah.
So it made it much more easier.
Yeah.
And I kind of didn't have to look for the, I didn't have to think at all what kind of, not that I think of what movements I'm doing, but sometimes it's more coming from the brain and sometimes it's just kind of coming from wherever, and it was more the second way.
So I'm not totally sure if I track, like most of what you're saying makes sense to me in this like realm. and then so as I hear you describe these moments, I'm not sure, like the thing that I am interested in interviewing in this is a moment during confusion.
Ah, okay.
Mm-hmm. And in particular because like coming from contact, especially like this strong orientation towards like flow, and then also but it seems to be like a real cultural orientation towards like, we want to feel good, you know, we want to like feel with ease. And I am interested in the same thing, and I'm sort of, almost like it was a coin on the other side of the coin, being like, oh, what happens in the confusion?
Mm-hmm.
And so for this reason, for this interview, I'm looking for a moment that, could be open to more words, but some of the words that come to mind for me are this like feeling awkward or confused, or maybe not good or bad, it could be either, but like kind of not knowing this, not understanding this. And so so like that's the moment that I was sort of wanting to dive into. Does that fit the one with me, or is that
No, actually not.
Okay, because as I hear it, I'm like, oh, it sounds different.
That was interesting to me because I was kind of looking for something like that. Like this approach was new to me and it was interesting what it made with me, but of course it was something that is more on the east side of what you mentioned. Yeah, it was not so much, though it was not a good feeling because the situation was not good, I was kind of...
Yeah.
Getting into still what happened was interesting and good to me.
Yeah.
Okay, but I get what you're looking for, I guess, yeah. The thing is, I really don't remember bad things very long.
Yeah.
I tend to...
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, not bad, no, but uncomfortable or something, so...
That's perfectly fine.
But I try to because I mentioned that at the beginning, it was a little bit awkward to dance with somebody else.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. But I think you need to lead me more.
Absolutely.
What are you looking on?
Yeah. No problem.
Yeah.
So what we'll do kind of is sort of like playing a videotape. And
mm-hmm.
I'm like, rewind the tape and play it again, rewind the tape and play it again.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Very much like a conversational improvisation, like really with you leading the dance, so
mm-hmm.
to speak. And I'll absolutely ask questions into.
Okay.
And kind of guide. So like the first question possibility for this is, pausing for just a second. Do you ever do like meditation or body scans? I mean, similar to what we did
yeah.
in class. Okay, so with each question, you're welcome to close your eyes or keep your eyes open.
Mm-hmm.
I've done entire interviews with both of our eyes shut, so that just happened. But to do this kind of very similar to that exercise, I got bring the question to all of yourself
mm-hmm.
and kind of reflect in a whole way before coming to answer.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll remind this as we go along. I'll bring it up again. But sort of like towards each question, kind of having this whole body asking.
Mm-hmm.
And so the first question would be, when we're like coming to this moment where there's this awkwardness.
Mm-hmm.
And just. Anything you don't remember is no problem. We'll just be checking for memory.
Mm-hmm.
It's not there. If you remember what you were doing right before you came into interaction with this kind of awkward.
Not that I really remember that situation, it's more like I think I scanned, sort of,
mm-hmm.
with my eyes, visually,
mm-hmm.
the room,
mm-hmm.
and the people.
Mm-hmm. Cool. And do you remember if it was an exercise with, like, instructions? Because there were some exercises
yeah.
that were, like, or was it in the improvisation time?
We have both situations. Was once in improvisation time and once during exercise.
Awesome. And then of those two, do you have one that, like, I don't know, seems a little more interesting? Or strong or something?
Maybe during improvisation was a little bit more, yeah.
Cool.
It's more clear.
Cool, yeah. And I find, like, just in case this is supporting, again, like, whatever emerges is cool and whatever doesn't is no problem.
Mm-hmm.
And I find in the process there seems to be a lot of information that comes up where, like, when I do it, I'm like, I never remembered that until I'm, like, in it.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have all this, like, information. So maybe just taking a slice of the improvisation one,
mm-hmm.
And kind of just talking through all the pieces that you remember of this moment, including the body shape or what maybe you were doing or felt like.
remember that there was a lot of eye contact and moving forth and back, like approaching, stepping back, approaching, so coming near, getting close, getting closer, and being somehow repelled. And I remember that feeling that I didn't want to, somehow I didn't want to get closer. And first, I think I remember I didn't follow that, so I kept trying to establish contact, but I noticed that I didn't want to.
Perfect.
So I was sort of farther back. Okay.
Cool. And then, what we're gonna kind of rewind about or like check in about is like if the line goes from here to here at the time of the whole class, and then we're zeroing in on this moment, and then we're also gonna look at like the entering the moment and the exiting the moment. And so it doesn't have to be told exactly in sequence. We'll figure it out as we go, but that's the rough like picture we're looking at. And so if from here, if you can remember, like even just rewinding the tape a tiny bit, like, do you remember right before you came in to this back and forth or like eye contact moment with this person? So if I have this right, like the memory kind of starts already in the interaction.
At least that's what I'm sure of. I mean, I could make up some. I have some ideas where I was coming from, that I was kind of moving on the floor and kind of. But I don't know. That's nothing I'm sure about. Maybe it's something.
It's also a bit of the process. I kind of everyone that I work with, and I'm already working with people that are like interested in doing this anyway, so we're kind of a particular lot. But it's really, I think it's been every single time that people are like, I don't know, am I making it up? Am I pretty sure this, but like this one less though, certain about this. So that's perfect what you say, like, oh, maybe this, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, but maybe it helps, or it kind of mirrors what happened before, is that I have this I think eye contact was really something very, sometimes in contact you have, I don't tend to look at people first to enter a dance. And that moment, I couldn't escape from that, sort of. It felt like, okay, now I'm in. And so I guess before I didn't look at that person, so maybe I was more kind of moving for myself. But what exactly I was doing, I can't tell you. But I think I was just for sure not having this focus with my eyes on the person.
And even in there, do you, without knowing kind of precisely what you're doing, do you have any memory of like how it felt at the time?
So the moment before. I think it was still quite at the beginning of the whole. Time frame, so I was still a little nervous and maybe felt a little clumsy. So, but I didn't have had any feelings towards the people before. I think it was the first time that I kind of had an emotion towards, okay, this is something that's coming to me and that's too much right now, so that's kind of I don't want that. Yeah.
Yeah.
And I didn't have that. I don't think I had that before.
Yeah. And then is this? I didn't quite understand. Is it so that just as a way to talk about it is how I break it up in my mind of like the second half or the last half of the class being this like memory.
Yeah.
So was it before in the first section or in that section?
It was in the first section.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. Quite soon after the beginning.
Uh-huh.
At the moment, shortly after the moment you kind of introduced the opportunity to dance together.
Yeah. And I think I'm not sure how about this. I think it was the three forms of contact. This real quick round of
mm-hmm.
like eye contact, abstract, and touch contact.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I wonder if it was even during that eye contact. I'm not sure.
I think it was after that.
Okay,
so when
cool.
you kind of we were more or less free.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So we had kind of done all these steps before.
Okay, cool.
I think so.
Yeah. Okay, so coming back, there was not some big idea that you were doing kind of your own thing and hadn't yet had an emotional kind of moment with anybody. No
so
big feeling
yeah.
so far. And then suddenly in this eye contact,
yeah,
the first kind of connecting moment with this person.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it was from the distance, definitely.
Okay.
Yeah.
And do you remember how far were you?
Maybe 2 or 3 meters or so.
Oh,
yeah.
Cool.
And I remember the person was sitting and I think I was standing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I'm inferring this was sort of a surprise to find our eyes. Like, were you looking at it?
Mm-hmm.
Just a way of understanding it.
I think it wasn't not so much a surprise to meet eyes, but the way. The surprise what was
yeah.
it? My reaction to it was
yeah.
a surprise to me.
Cool.
Yeah.
Okay, and then so diving into this reaction, can
yeah.
you describe how it felt?
I thought that somebody wants something from me, something so special, and I kind of
yep. yeah.
didn't
watch
it.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so, and then in this, like, this exact, like, perfect description of, like, somebody wanting something, is there, so this can be like internal and also external information. Like your eyes are open, so the way I think of it to myself or the words I use are like sensing inside or sensing into the world.
Mm-hmm.
And any sensing in there being perfectly fitting.
Mm-hmm.
Wondering like, one way to ask it is like, how do you know somebody wants something from you? Like what lights up? Or what
mm-hmm.
do you feel that arrives into this?
I think it was the way this look was, because it was very, very, it was not like a side blink or, it was very, very focused and very sending, sort of.
Yeah.
Or at least that's how I received it.
Absolutely,
yeah. It was
yeah,
not
that
way.
Yeah,
no one knows where. Yeah. I don't know. Yeah, like I said, I tend not to. I try actually not really to have too much eye contact while dancing, because it kind of, maybe I'm a person that's kind of, it puts me under pressure, sort of.
Yeah.
Or it's yeah, I'm kind of losing my connection at that. I kind of lost my connection to myself at that moment, I think. Kind of like, and I don't have that so much when I enter something with a touch. It's like a different way to communicate. I don't know why it's so. Funny, because I mean, touch is something very personal. While a look we have all the time with different people on the street or something.
This actually happens quite when it, because in this format, especially like in a lot of my work, I highlight these differentiated forms of contact, and it's something I find quite frequently where people are like, "Whoa, eye contact! I feel it super strong."
Yeah.
And I agree with you. Like
yeah.
we do eye contact with strangers all the time, and we don't touch strangers all the time.
Yeah.
But when you do it sort of intentionally.
Yeah.
So I'm wondering about this, like, this sending.
Yeah.
Like, kind of like reimagining the sending, and if you can see, like, where on you lights up in that, like, a recall of this eye sending.
Right in my body.
Yeah.
But I remember the kind of I freeze, or I kind of lose the flow. My joints get stiff,
yeah.
And I kind of it probably wouldn't see it from outside, but it's kind of the feeling
yeah.
I have at that moment.
And
it's,
is it upward?
I tend to.
Yeah,
to I think I tend to hide, maybe, then, or to make me small, kind of shield myself from that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember that I kind of was, I didn't like that reaction from myself, so I kind of pushed myself into the look in kind of to you can't do that now, you can't kind of hide, or you only feel four people, so you got to yeah, that's silly.
Yeah. And do you remember did those thoughts come up, or was there like, so right after this, like, so right after the hiding and shielding, like the very next kind of like microsecond.
Yeah.
Do you remember?
I think it went pretty fast that I kind of tried to get back.
Yeah.
And these, I don't think I had these thoughts so precisely, but I think that was the reason why I got into this contact again. But then it happened again. Like I said, it was a forth and back.
Yeah,
and
absolutely. But like this push, this like right after the shift, and then there's this push to like re-engage.
Mm-hmm.
And wondering even that push, like, do you feel that push come from anywhere, or is it outside of yourself or inside of yourself?
Inside.
Uh-huh.
I didn't have to do anything with the person.
Uh-huh.
There was nothing, she was not doing nothing.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think, it was completely from my, not even from my body, but from my brain. It was not a body reaction, like, or a move or something, but it was, my cognition wanted me to sort of not behave that way.
Uh-huh.
But I don't really remember the I don't have a real body thought of that moment. It's kind of, I really have it here,
yeah,
but I don't have it so much in my body.
And this is a, this is like a piece that's fascinating to me that I don't have any, so what I'm wondering is like, I hear the word brain and I hear the gestures, I mean, I see the gestures coming and I hear the word cognition and the gestures are coming up in the forehead area. And wondering if there's sensation there, or it's because we there's no way to like, I can't, you know, we can't like completely parse out. Like we think of like, oh, our head is here, we're thinking. So like, there's
mm-hmm.
all of this cultural
mm-hmm.
information of this gesture, but also, I'm wondering if there, if it, like if it felt like it was coming from up here, or if there's just no feeling whatsoever.
I remember myself thinking,
mm-hmm.
so I guess it came from there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so then this like rewinding the PSA. So there's like suddenly eye contact from a couple meters away, approximately, and then this perception of them wanting something, ascending through the eyes,
mm-hmm.
and then feeling the reaction of the hide shield,
mm-hmm.
and then the push, which is sort of unfelt, but a memory of the sort of abstract thought at this
mm-hmm.
time. And
then? Re-establishing eye contact.
Uh-huh.
And
so
approaching. So yeah, I kind of can,
uh-huh.
I kind of
yeah.
cut it for a moment,
yeah.
and then re-established it.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember that we approached.
Mm-hmm.
So I approached her because she was, I think she was sitting on the floor or something,
mm-hmm.
so, yeah, which is, when I think back, it's a little funny to me because I hesitated the contact, but I still established this eye contact, plus I kind of moved towards it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then even in the, no big deal if you remember the sequence, but this approach towards and the eye contact, did the eye contact come first before the approach, or was it sort of simultaneous?
I think it was first eye contact and then move.
Uh-huh. And did you, and this back and forth, I'll let you go.
Yeah, the back and forth was constant eye contact,
uh-huh.
and then we didn't cut it at all.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Yeah.
And so in the second eye contact, you know, like after the push and then the re-establishing of eye contact, did you notice the same reaction or sensation, or was it different this time?
I think, in contrast to the first eye contact, it was like the first
mm-hmm.
reaction was more like more a
a reflex.
That more reflex?
Yeah.
While the second and after that eye contact and cut eye contact were different, so that they were more yeah. So the first was a reflex, and I noticed my feelings when I had already looked away, I think. And then I kind of try to reestablish to check, maybe. Is it still there? Is it still the same? It was still there, but it was not so surprising. So the next reaction was not so intense. So it was more, it shifted a little bit. It became a play, I think.
Uh-huh.
So with the person, because this person kind of started to do this forth and back as well.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then it was more like a communication, more like a... It had a form,
yeah.
Sort of,
yeah.
And yeah, that made it then easier for me. So kind of, that was the moment when it shifted from awkward to a new form. Because I remember that I thought, does this person have the same feeling to this? To this look of mine, because she behaved a little bit like it, like she also, but maybe she just, I thought she's mirroring me, but I didn't feel this, or my thoughts were not, now she's wanting something from me, or
yes,
so, but it was something else.
And these thoughts about like what's going on for her, did that happen once? So as I heard it, I heard there was the reflex, and then the was the shield,
mm-hmm.
and then the push, and this like kind of not quite clear thinking,
mm-hmm.
not quite clear words, but thinking,
mm-hmm.
And then a reestablishment of eye contact,
mm-hmm.
and then in this. Less intense feeling happened that was more playful,
mm-hmm.
and then so it was it during this time that the thinking about what she's thinking happened, like had it already shifted from like this intense phase?
Yeah, I think it was at that time, because it took a couple of forth and backs to see sort of the system,
uh-huh.
that it's something,
yeah.
it was not accidentally, but it was, we had established something.
Uh-huh.
And that's why I think it already took some moments before I thought, is she reacting? Me, or is she mirroring me, or am I mirroring her right now? What's going on? Yeah.
Okay, so then even just rewinding just a hair to this moment of establishing the,
mm-hmm.
the system.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember you were saying like already it's less intense and more playful.
Mm-hmm.
Was it playful in the establishing of the system, or did the playful come after? Like, how did the establishing of the system feel?
I think it felt good because we both had something, we were kind of on track again.
Uh-huh.
It gave security, yeah, I
okay.
think, somehow, to have something to work on from both sides,
yeah.
maybe.
And do you remember sort of like,
I don't know if I mentioned that motion came in, so
oh,
we
yeah.
kind of,
okay.
it was not just look, but kind of we both were rocking forth and back and approaching each other, and but then also taking a distance again.
And then I'm wondering, like I don't quite think I have it. It's like it feels really close, but I'm like I'm not quite sure. This shield, push, re-eye contact, and then this like I'm a little bit unclear if it was a like immediate shift in intensity with this like less surprise upon the eye contact and already the playfulness was there, or did it sort of like was it like a gradual?
Gradual.
Oh, this is fun.
It was gradual.
Okay.
Yeah. With each repetition,
it
kind of became more system and it was more playful, more clear, more precise. Okay, we're doing that.
Yeah.
So yeah, no, it gained intensity. And it was more loose also, so with kind of rocking and
yeah. And then this, I'm wondering if this thing you said from the beginning of like I can't quite remember your words, so please correct what I say. But something to the extent of like kind of doing what you didn't want to be doing. And as I hear you describe this already like system established, had that kind of already passed? Like I'm trying to integrate these two.
Ah, okay.
Fragments.
No, that was you mean if I have this, I have the feeling to have to do something that I don't want to do during this playful, but no, that was really, really at the beginning.
Just in this moment of shield?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
right, for the first eye contact.
Yeah, yeah.
There was milliseconds. It was just,
yeah.
It was not real. There was nothing, but it was just, that was my impression at the moment.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was really at the very beginning, yeah.
And then I get like coming back to this moment of reflex and this like this eye contact and this sending. Is there anything about this person like more that you could describe? Like anything in the space between you two or in this person, or like if not, no big deal.
Yeah, it's I remember that the person was watching me from quite deep from the floor. So it was a little bit like I had the image of a tiger or something.
Oh yeah.
So it was something.
Oh, that's fascinating.
That was sitting there waiting for something.
And do you, the like image of the tiger popping into the mind, is it, do you remember that happening then, or just is it now in hindsight where you're like, oh, they were kind of...
Yeah, no, I think I had that image already at the, that moment.
And then do you remember anything about the tonality of their body?
The tonality?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
Like muscle tension.
Ah,
like
okay.
How the muscles
are. Ah, yeah, okay,
so.
Yeah. Ready to jump?
Cool. Okay.
But also, just watching, but being prepared, something like that.
Yeah. That makes tons of sense to me.
Okay.
it really does. And then it's interesting. So let me see if I can retell this arc again and then like adding in or like correcting So there's this you're doing something kind of like into your own, and then suddenly there's eye contact, and there's maybe some thought of like they're a tiger, and maybe some information about they look ready to pounce or something. And it feels like they're sending something to this eye contact, and it makes a reflex of the shielding. And then there's a thinking that's like a push to re-engage, and you re-establish eye contact, and then in a gradual but like pretty swift way, the physicality of back and forth and already in the whole, that you establish a system like pretty immediately, and that it, the second eye contact feels less intense already, like less surprise.
Not necessarily less intense, but less frightening or less uncomfortable. Frightening is the wrong word. Uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Yeah. Was not. It didn't lose any or any intensity. But it, my reaction to it shifted from to okay. That's what I mean with I couldn't read it. First I didn't know what that look was, maybe, and then by adding these forth and backs and these interactions, I concluded that it's interest and playfulness, and yeah, that I needed this movement to add this information.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
Yeah, to make sense of it.
Yeah.
And
because
this,
before this person was still, she didn't move at all.
Okay, yeah.
Maybe that's, yeah.
That's another thing, yeah.
Another detail I didn't mention.
Yeah, it's great. I mean, stuff just always comes up. So.
Yeah.
And in this like second eye contact that was also intense, could you describe or differentiate how you felt it? Like, I quite know what you mean in a way, you know, where I'm like, oh, things can be equally intense but different.
Yeah.
And I'm wondering, can you describe the sensations
yeah.
of the differences?
I think the first look made me shield or fold away, and then the second look, when we established this exploring and forth and back, I didn't feel the urge to shield.
Yeah.
It was more like an interest in, yeah, let's find out what's going on here.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
I can handle this. That's interesting. Yeah, it was more interesting than confusing, maybe. That's why I kept this eye contact and this play, and I kind of wanted to find out what this look was. Interesting. When I think about these different looks and how I reacted to it, I feel like this first one is something I kind of use also more often on the street, because sometimes if you catch somebody's eyes or something, I cut it quite quickly. But there it's okay. But in this context, I wasn't prepared. Somehow I wasn't prepared for that. And the second look, yeah, was a completely different category.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It totally makes sense. I wonder about, like, I'm curious of some nuanced details in there that I kind of have questions to. But the overall framing makes absolute sense. And I wonder, like, so a couple questions and mm-hmm. picking up whichever one you want, and we can look at the others also later. They're kind of getting at the same thing, like, so there's this intense and reflex in the first book in the ascending shield fold.
Mm-hmm.
And wondering, so one way to say it is, like, I'm kind of understanding the action as a shield and a fold.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you're actually doing that with your body, even on a micro level inside. And I'm wondering, which parts of you do you feel in that activity?
I think I feel it in my own body, like
mm-hmm.
on a micro level,
mm-hmm.
that I can feel it, but I feel it like a tension
mm-hmm.
in this part.
Okay, cool.
So,
yeah. And does it, I very much see where your hand is, and I'm wondering, is it like just the front of your chest, or is it also the back? Is it like considering this whole region of your body? Is it really
mm-hmm.
in the front or middle or? How far does it go?
I think it's more like the center, and it's folding around the center.
Mm-hmm.
So it sits in on a deeper level, so it's
mm-hmm.
yeah. And I fold around this.
yeah. So it's like underneath the skin for
yeah.
sure, and it
yeah.
folds in on that, and it's in the center. And then is it like in the so this like front and back? Is it like in the center of the front and back, or just in the like center of the left and the right?
Mm-hmm. In the front part, in the center of the front part.
Yeah. Okay. Totally. perfect. And then there's the thought push and the re-engagement and the intense but like with interest, this like different category.
Yeah.
And in a real similar way, like checking to see, do you feel that one anywhere? Or everywhere or nowhere?
I remember my body better.
Mm-hmm.
So I remember that I was moving more, and that there was more and no stiffness,
mm-hmm.
or not so much. It kind of lost its
mm-hmm.
stiffness. And I felt like I had more room to move.
Mm-hmm.
So it was not like. Before I felt quite limited.
Yeah.
Limited?
Limited. Yeah.
Limited, that's the word, yeah.
And this is a weird question, but like, do you, in the limited and free to move, like, in the sort of abstract way, could you say, like,
where?
How limited? Yeah, like,
yeah.
Where did the.
I, I could move my arms and legs very far in the unlimited way before I feel like the radius of what my I remember really is this, so
yeah.
My extremities are not really part of my of how I remember that scene.
Yeah.
It's a really small, maybe not even there, maybe it's just this, I don't even remember my legs or so, yeah.
Yeah.
It's like the focus was before like this, and then
totally
it kind of
really makes sense, yeah.
Opened.
Yeah.
Opened up.
And then like coming back to this, the interest, like once the interest was there, this like very different intense.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's more space,
mm-hmm.
and you feel it, you have more body memory like all over.
Mm-hmm.
And then in that, like, is there anything more, like any kind of like details in there you can describe? Like, is it more intense anywhere, or is it everywhere?
I remember that at a certain moment my thoughts kicked in again, so this moving was quite intuitive,
mm-hmm.
but then my thoughts kicked in and I kind of tried to figure out, okay, let's see where, what happens or where you, okay, there's this feeling again, I don't want to go closer, stop. Okay, there's this feeling again. I want to go back.
Mm-hmm.
And that was connected with we did move, and I remember moving, but I don't remember so much my feelings again. But I remember the thoughts of analyzing what I'm doing or what we are doing.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But there's kind of a span between this. We establish this forth and back, and
mm-hmm.
it's becoming playful. And I don't remember thinking of that time,
mm-hmm.
having thoughts. And then, like I said, my thoughts kicked in again, and
mm-hmm.
then my memories shift from my body to my thoughts again. So
mm-hmm.
I don't really. I can't tell you where I felt.
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah.
And again, checking, but like not needing to, noticing like it are, again, like following the hand gestures, but like that doesn't necessarily mean anything.
Mm.
Did you feel the thoughts in your head, or did you feel your head kind of in any way at that time? When
yeah,
you didn't feel
I felt more my head or my thoughts in my brain than in my body.
Awesome, okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
When the well, I wanna back up just one more second before getting into that, so I don't lose it. Just this one more question about like the feeling of interest, like before the second thought kicked in.
Mm-hmm.
In the time of the interest,
mm-hmm.
of it,
mm-hmm.
and this like body. More space again.
Mm-hmm.
Checking again if there's any like were the same parts activated or different parts activated. I mean, already it sounds different because your whole body's activated, whereas
mm-hmm.
before it's just this limited
mm-hmm.
frame. And wondering like, yeah, if there's any more detailed information of like how, like if there was movement or like any dynamics to other descriptions.
Yeah. I remember that I approached the other person, and the other person reacted in bad ways by approaching me,
mm-hmm.
still on this level, and I remember that I took my body back
mm-hmm.
as a reaction, and then went into it again, and this happened a couple of times.
Mm-hmm.
And then the other person started to move backwards also.
Mm-hmm.
It was before only my part.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember that I don't really remember how I remember I noticed it, but I don't remember how I reacted to it.
Mm-hmm.
But it was still very much led by the look, by the gaze.
Yeah.
So it was like this was the main connection, and the body was just following this
mm-hmm.
somehow.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And this like main connection on the eyes. I'm just like guessing here. I'm just kind of imagining from own experience, and then also watching the movement. So like, I'm wondering if there's any like. Like magnet or repulsion quality, or if it stayed consistent feeling.
No, it was definitely the first
like
magnet and repulsion.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And
though the quality didn't change, it was something that I remembered that
yeah.
From trying to remember it kind of is a little irritating to me because I don't find the reason why. Maybe it was, I was trying to get more information of the look by reacting differently to it.
Uh-huh.
Like trying to
yeah.
get information
yeah,
somehow
yeah.
by approaching or getting back. But the quality of the look didn't change, and there was something that I remember irritated me.
Awesome, yeah.
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 And and just checking again on like a body scan way, but if not, no. Do you remember? Like, how do you know this? How do you know it bothers you? How do you know there's irritation? What do you feel anything?
I didn't know how to move. That's how
uh-huh.
I.
Uh-huh.
And there was no. Direct connection to my body.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. In this flash of irritation.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
It's like this look stuck here, and usually somehow something happens if you're in contact with a person.
Yeah.
Naturally, in the best
yeah.
in the good moment,
yeah.
but I think that's the awkward moment when
absolutely.
it sticks.
Yeah.
It gets stuck in your
yeah.
in your. It felt like it stuck in my brain,
uh-huh, uh-huh, uh-huh.
and I couldn't get it into my body.
Yeah. And the not knowing how to move, and like the irritation feeling. I'm just like just guessing here. Like, was it more like a stiffness, or a no feeling, or a numbness, or like a frozenness, or something totally different?
Like a marionette?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, I have all the
uh-huh.
parts, and I know I have access, but I don't know what to do with
uh-huh,
it.
Uh-huh.
But I feel like I need something to do with it.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, cool. and so then, in the, like, not receiving more information and having this, like, irritation response of, like, I still don't know. this is like my interpretation.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wondering, like, was there more playfulness found before, like, the second reemergence of like thinking happened?
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
By establishing this
uh-huh.
forth and back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, like, once she started doing it with you, without.
I think I was the one initiating something because I couldn't handle this situation of not knowing. I felt like I could not just stand back.
Yeah.
Or I didn't want to. I couldn't stand. No, it was more like the urge to, I can't do it.
Yeah.
I wanted to add something to that and see if that kind of clears the air. And then the other person kind of jumped in, taking that and doing corresponding or taking that what I gave in and so that was kind of the moment when I that I would describe as more playful and more secure because
And do you remember if like then how the feeling inside of you changed once it shifted to more playful, more secure?
And that's the moment when I kind of gained access to my
webs.
Again, it was not just, okay.
That totally makes sense,
Okay, now I know what I needed for, or what I, how I, how it makes sense to move in this situation. Not sense in a logical way, but in a
way. And just checking for like one more, I think, something in this, like in the marionette, then like in the thought of like of a irritation of the not knowingness of the snook. I can't think of a way I ask this. This isn't like directly related to what I'm experiencing, or I'm thinking of like these moments when I'm irritated, or like when I don't know, and I want something to happen and it's not happening. And I like I'm imagining this marionette and this like disembodied sort of like there's thoughts, but there's like not, and that you don't know how to move your body. But like it's like as I imagine the marionette. It's like also kind of relaxed in this marionette pose, but the story doesn't sound relaxed. And I wonder, like, are there other dynamics there? But like maybe not.
I think this marionette image. It's more about. That it's a passive. You move passively in when you're on these strings, and I felt that that was a feeling I had that I don't have access. But not in a good way, because sometimes you move fluently and you feel like it's not you, maybe. You're not moving consciously, but that's different. It's like. Maybe it's a wrong image. Maybe it's more like the area I can actively take action or decide what to do kind of shrinks together and becomes this smaller area and these parts are outside and
like you don't have access to them
I don't have access they are not even important I'm not interested in them in that moment.
So it does feel like you could have access. This is a weird question, but you just.
Well, I mean, I could. Some seconds later, I had.
But
you mean, it's a decision if I. Is that the question?
Yeah, well, it's like so much of what you're saying makes sense, and then like just like I'm trying to get like even more fine toothed about like really seeping up this experience, and so I'm not even sure what questions to ask. I'm like, there's this moment of irritation, and the space that you can move in, you're like in this. And I guess the question is sort of like this confusion for me of like, are these, I like, I hear you're not interested in these limbs, these extremities. But if they feel like you could use them if you wanted to or not, I guess it's like the only way I can think of asking. But it's not super important, it's just...
It's interesting to me as well. Let me try to feel it. Try to find the difference between this state of being and the one when I later on when I felt more freedom to move. I think in the first situation it was more secure not to move.
Cool. Okay.
I don't know why, but maybe because I couldn't connect, because I didn't know what was going on, so I kind of...
And it was like this, but slightly different than the initial reflection.
So, it was more... a little bit like the pose of the other person. There was kind of down and looking and waiting, and a little bit like a tiger. Maybe in a way my reaction to it was similar when I but more on the feeling level. It doesn't make sense to myself.
But it does, I don't know, it does make some sense to me.
I think it's this look, this first look, this intense, frightening,
like reflex.
That took sort of so much energy and so much focus that it, it all went way out of all my other. It's like it took the capacities of, or limited them to this. One sense, and I, So it's rather a focus question than did I want them to move or could I move them. I think I wasn't really aware of them because my focus was so much on this look.
It does make sense.
Whereas later on, the situation was clearer. I didn't need to put all to find all the information in this look anymore. But there were more. There was more space to get information through other details, and that kind of allowed me to. to get some to my body again, to
mm-hmm. And this was sort of a gradual shift, this move from like even the second look already still kind of in this like focused shrink it and then
gradually
kind of understanding came in
insecurity.
And this playful interest,
mm-hmm.
A real quick check again of like, do you feel that in any particular way?
I got it from the reaction, I think, that something was happening.
Mm-hmm.
So I was
like seeing physically something happening.
Yeah. Reactions on my approach.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And that this dynamic established.
Mm-hmm.
And it gave me security because it was something to follow and to build up onto, I guess, that was important too.
Yeah.
There was something to work on.
So the action itself completely makes sense. And then I wonder, towards the feeling,
mm-hmm.
of, like, what does the security feel like? Or what does the playful feel like? Like, how do you know?
Where in the body?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Or it could be out of the body, too, but how do you experience it?
I think the eye contact was less dense. Dense,
mm-hmm,
so
mm-hmm.
It was still there, but it was less dense.
Mm-hmm.
I remember the dynamic of my body, so this rocking forth and back, that's something that's very present.
Mm-hmm.
So compared to the body sensations I have before, that are still very, not very, I don't remember them very well, but that I remember that it was and then there was I could reach emotions as well. So before there was nothing I could read, but then I could read emotions and that kind of gave me security, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
But how did I feel? I dared to move more. I think I kind of did not dare to do too much.
Yeah.
But then I moved more freely.
And so, in one way, like, following the words you were saying before, like the space opened up again around you.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's like, maybe even, like, the possibility of, like, asking your head and asking your chest and asking your belly or your hips or your legs or your arms. That moment of feeling secure, like, is it a thought? Is it, like, what lets you know you're secure?
Mm-hmm.
Like, not any of the moving or so, but, like, the
feeling.
Yeah, direct sensation.
Mm-hmm.
Like, direct.
I don't really remember the feeling in my body. I remember it more in the brain than in the body. Yeah.
Do you remember in the brain, was there words or was it just sort of like not yet words thought? You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Or like, what did you feel in the brain? I guess is the better word.
established is rocking, kind of. Mm-hmm. That's something that's very much in the body. It's not in the brain, but that kind of gave me security.
Mm-hmm.
This form.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't. I can't nail it down on.
Mm-hmm.
On the.
Where are you?
It's on a certain area in my body where I felt it.
Uh-huh.
Because maybe I didn't feel it completely, because it was better than at the beginning, but I still didn't feel really comfortable in the situation.
Yeah. Uh-huh. That makes sense.
Yeah.
So there's some, like, is this in my some kind of overall not clear, vague sensation that you're secure, but not really identifying? Like, you feel something in your brain, but not really feel it in the body. You feel the motion of the rocking.
I felt, or I thought, I felt more curiosity.
Yeah,
I think that's.
Yeah.
That's it, kind of.
Yeah. Or even that, yeah. If you,
yeah.
Uh-huh.
And that allowed me to move.
Yeah. It's like these three words are really interesting to me, are like sparking my own kind of like, this interest, curiosity, and insecure, and they all feel kind of like very of the same moment,
mm-hmm.
interchanged, and I wonder, like, even when I say these words, is there like anything in you that like moves?
Mm-hmm.
The curiosity.
Yeah, curiosity is open. It's just the, it's the feeling, what I described before. This,
uh-huh.
It's just the opposite of that.
Amazing.
So.
Okay. Yeah. So same region.
Yeah. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
It's even the same point.
Yep.
The same.
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah.
That very much matches my experience. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It makes a lot of sense to me.
Okay.
Many levels. Yeah. And I guess also the playful is another word that you use that is of the same as that.
Yeah. It's you need to be open here, to be playful,
mm-hmm.
I think.
Mm-hmm. And this opening, so like, this is another kind of like watching my hands, but it doesn't always, the hands aren't always directly doing what's happening, but like, is it, it's like, does the opening happen within your own skin, or does it like extend beyond your body?
It feels like it's extending.
Yeah.
It's like really like a door or something that's opening. Work.
Uh-huh.
But yeah. And but then your yeah. I think I only do that when I'm really, really at ease with the situation.
Yeah,
because it's kind of, you're open.
Yeah. Do you know? Do you like? Is it roughly like how far from you?
At that situation.
That moment, yeah.
I opened a door, but
uh-huh.
It's not like there. It could be. It could be this.
Yeah.
But it was.
Yeah, but just here in this time.
Mm. Well, before it was closed, and then it gradually opened to maybe this,
uh-huh.
So that I could easily close it
again. Yeah, totally. And then was it, okay, so these are like, this gives me a lot of spatial information, like it's, the door was about this open,
mm-hmm.
And wondering like, how, so, maybe, okay, I would say like width and then depth.
Yeah.
And so it looks like this is width.
Yeah.
And then the depth wise, was it also about handling? That like you've...
It shifted. I think that's why I moved forward and back to figure out the depth that was possible, if it was still comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I remember that I noticed that this is not comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
This is okay, but it's losing intensity on the interest. So forth again. And then I remember the other person did something and that kind of brought me away from my scan. How do I feel? But I just reacted.
Mm-hmm.
But that was comfortable because I wasn't scanning so much.
Mm-hmm.
I was not so much in my brain.
Mm-hmm. I now give you this possibility. For me, for the thing that I'm going for, I feel like we already went through an arch, and as I hear this interaction,
mm-hmm.
it's like it sounds like there's more arches to it, like
mm-hmm.
there's more waves of like already the things I heard you saying, or like even this reaction, or then like the thoughts came. Basically, like, we could kind of close it here, or if you want to keep exploring, feel welcome,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Do you want to... So you mean in this scene,
mm-hmm.
you find more...
Yeah,
the
way I would sort of, kind of doing this thing again where I, tell what I hear
mm-hmm.
sort of in a short way, and then
mm-hmm.
you let me know. So it's like this, you're doing something unto yourself and then you find yourself in eye contact and you're noticing this like tiger kind of ready to move, still position with this person and this like sending that has a reflex that's a closing shield.
Mm-hmm.
And then thought push to re-engage. And then this dynamic that like takes a bit of time to unfold of like this being okay with the eye contact, but like so it's not as surprise intense as the first time, but that there's still this like only small area available
mm-hmm.
or like not available, but you're focused on the gaze,
mm-hmm.
and then this is like also kind of accompanied with this word like irritation of like figuring out what's happening.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's in the moving, once this person changed something and
mm-hmm.
stopped being like exactly the same, then there was some somewhat gradual shift to like the doors opening a little bit and
mm-hmm.
this more playful,
mm-hmm.
curious
mm-hmm.
Thing. And then already for me, like just even arriving at this moment, even if it's not like full capacity playful, but it's like riding through, it's like you're doing something and then it's like a bump and then you find a, like a little open curiosity in there.
Mm-hmm.
And then it goes into a little bit more like more thinking and more like navigation and etc.
Mm-hmm.
And so the arch I'm speaking of is like just even arriving to like a small moment of opening,
mm-hmm.
already that being like, oh, that's kind of imperfect. One arch,
mm-hmm.
and then since the moment has like actually, because like maybe it's like maybe 1 second at a time or something, or like
yeah.
two, you know.
Yeah.
So there could be like more episodes or like more, not even necessarily like the same arch, but like more things happen
mm-hmm.
in this exchange
mm-hmm.
that we can explore,
mm-hmm.
or like that even this one arch is okay,
mm-hmm.
like for kind of what I'm getting at.
Okay.
Because it's fascinating, and I also know it's tiring.
Yeah.
So like I feel real open of like, are you? Do you want to like add stuff? Do you want to like? Are there points that like feel really like exciting, like or important to mention? You know, like feel open. and no pressure.
So the way you retold this art feels quite accurate to what I think to remember. Well, what I tried to communicate, which is amazing because I thought I would never get this information to another person.
Totally.
That's
kind totally, of, I understand.
Yeah, it's impressive that it's possible. I try to think of how this scene finished, or how we got out of it, or if how it kind of developed. But I really have it. Obviously, it was not so important to me that I remember it really well. So I remember.
Like the thoughts came back up after the small playful opening, is that right?
Yeah. But I can't recall if we even really met each other. I don't know.
Yeah, like a full.
Yeah.
Yeah, I totally understand.
Yeah. I think I can go on in this
cool.
scene.
Yeah.
Because it's kind of, this was so impressive, so important at that moment.
Yeah. Like strong or something.
Yeah, like strong. But I remember that we had this distance and you made this, you told us to approach each other. One had the eyes closed and the other person, I don't remember, I think we both had the eyes closed, or we could choose the approaching person also wants to close the eyes.
And the touch one.
Exactly, and feel how it feels to be close.
Yeah.
And yeah, I remember that we had this, or I had this, that was the same person I was doing it with.
Okay, yeah.
And the dynamic was very quite similar.
Uh-huh.
And I don't even remember if this was before or after. But I think it was before. It was before. Yeah. But it's interesting because there was no look.
Yeah. And then such a similar dynamic still.
Yeah.
That is really fascinating, actually. Do you remember who it was with?
I don't remember her name.
Like
she had long little curled hair and short top and...
Rebecca. I can check too. I think there was a. Both of my phones were dying. The phones that I...
No, really, both.
Well, yeah. So they're both like, this is a new one.
Yeah.
But they both were like on the brink of death. And then when I went to like upload the videos from my phone, the first day was no problem. And the second day, let me check, because I might have the video.
Yeah.
But I'm not sure if I have the video, because it might have been on. That camera might have been on one of the phones that never will give me that video again. Movement sessions. Yeah, I think part two. Oh yeah, absolutely. It's the first door is the kitchen and then the second door is the toilet. Yeah, I only have the camera from part two. So,